First, we are going to discuss regulation. So here organisms we call these the regulators. Here the organisms we are called regulators. Some of the organisms are able to maintain homeostasis by physiological reactions. Okay, some of the organisms are able to maintain the homeostasis by physiological reactions. Such a physiological reaction which ensure the constant body temperature. Constant body temperature and osmotic concentration of body fluids. Osmotic concentration of the body fluids. Once again, this point: some of the organisms able to maintain the homeostasis. Homeostasis means what I said. The organism to maintain the constant of its internal environment. How here the homeostasis by physiological reactions. The constant body temperature and osmotic concentration of the body fluids. Understand? Next, one more point. All birds, and also mammals. All birds and also mammals and lower vertebrates. Lower vertebrates and also invertebrates. Invertebrates to maintain such a regulation. So what are the homeostasis? They maintain, that means what are the homeostasis by physiological reaction? The physiological reaction that ensures the constant body temperature and osmotic concentration of the body fluids. So all the birds and also mammals and lower invertebrates and also vertebrates to maintain such a regulation. Okay, next point. Success of mammals. You see, success of mammals. Here the success of mammals is large. Okay, the success of mammals here large due to maintain the constant body temperature. Okay, the success of mammals is large due to maintain the constant body temperature. They grow and live in the Antarctic and also Sahara desert region. Sahara desert region. What is meant by here success of mammals? Here, what is the meaning? Here, success of mammals. Success of mammals means the mammals to produce in the new organism. That means generation after generation. The success of mammals means the mammals to produce in the new organism. Number of generations. That's we call it is a success of mammals. Once again, see this point. Success of mammals means so the organism. What are the organisms here? Mammals. The mammals are continuously can be producing of it is the new organisms. That means new offsprings. Every generation continuously, one by one, it can be production of it is the new organisms. That's we call it is the success of mammals. The success of mammals is very large. That means continuously can be production of the success of mammals is large. Due to maintain its constant temperature So that's why they are living in Antarctic and also Sahara Desert regions. Next point. The mechanism of mammals. The mechanism of mammals to regulate their body temperature is similar to the humans. Okay. The mechanism of mammals. What are the mammals they maintain? Constant body temperature. That is also same in the human beings. That is same in the human youths. Next point. In that, particularly, we maintain the constant body temperature. The constant body temperature 37 degrees. 37 degrees. Okay. So we are maintaining the constant body temperature 37 degrees. And during the summer time, you can see. That means in summer, outside temperature is more than our body. So how we are maintaining homeostasis? Okay. In summer, outside temperature is more than our body. Automatically, what will happen? In our body, it is a sweat profusely come out. So whenever the sweat profusely come out, automatically what will happen? The body make it cooling. So that's why brings down the body temperature. So once again, see this point. So in summer, the outside temperature is more than in our body. The sweat profusely comes out. So the body make a cooling. So automatically, so we are surviving such a situation. That means your body maintain the homeostasis. Next, in the winter. In winter, outside temperature is lower. Outside is temperature is lower than our body. So what will you do here? How it is we are maintain the homeostasis? So in winter, outside temperature is lower than our body. Automatically in our body make a shivering. So that's why we have to do some exercises. That means rubbing like this. Okay, we have to do some exercises. So it raises the temperature. Automatically in our body reaches the homeostasis. That means we are maintaining the constant internal environment. Okay, this is the regulation. So such organisms, all these organisms are, we call such a constant body temperature maintain, constant osmotic concentration we maintain. So that's how you call it is these organisms, we call it is the regulators. Okay, once again, this regulator means some of the organisms are able to maintain the homeostasis by physiological reaction, which ensure the constant body temperature and also osmotic concentration. And all the birds and also mammals, lower vertebrates, invertebrates, to maintain the constant such a regulation. That means particularly it is the thermal regulation and also osmotic regulation also. Next, the success of mammals is large due to maintain the constant body temperature. Particularly, you can see Antarctic and Sahara Desert. So that's why such a mammals to grow and also live there such a area. Next, the mechanism of mammals is similar to the human beings. And also, that means the mechanism of mammals to regulate their body temperature, that is similar in human use. Next point, we are maintaining the constant body temperature, it is the 37 degrees. In summer, the outside temperature is more than our body. So that's why what will happen, the sweat is profusely comes out and then body make it cooling. So it is reaches that constant internal environment. And during the winter also, the outside temperature is much lower than our body. So that's what will happen, the body make a shivering. So you can do some exercises to regulate their body temperature. Finally, we are maintaining the homeostasis. So that's why this is a regulation features. What are the regulators? Next, second one, confirm. Here, majority of the plants and animals cannot maintain the constant internal environment. The body temperature is changes with that of ambient temperature. What is here meaning? It is ambient temperature changes. Ambient temperature is changes. That means atmosphere, the temperature, it can be changes. What are the organisms are living? That means in surrounding, what are the animals and plants and human beings are living? Their body temperature also can be changes. So such organisms we call confirmers. Every season you can see, summer, rainy season, winter season, there are different temperatures are present. So what are the atmosphere temperature is present, that based upon in our body temperature we will changes. Okay, based on atmosphere temperature, based upon in our body maintain and also changes the temperature condition. That's why in the atmosphere in our body they are equality they maintain. That's why we are maintaining the homeostatic depending upon the temperature or maybe osmotic concentration of the body fluids also. Okay, that's it. In some of the aquatic animals, the osmotic concentration of body fluids changes with that of surrounding water osmotic concentration also. Surrounding which one? Water. Water osmotic concentration. Okay. So some of the aquatic animals, the osmotic concentration of the body fluids, it can be changes. What will happen? The surrounding water osmotic concentration also. Such organisms we call it is conformers. We are little bit of confusion is present. Once again see, what are the aquatic region, the living, what are the aquatic region, the presence of animals or any living organisms. In different seasons, water, the osmotic concentration can be different. Water, how much of it is the osmotic concentration, it can be maintained. Osmotic concentration means here the, it may be salt concentration maybe. So in inland water having less than 5 is present, and also sea water it can be 30 to 35 is present. So that means these main osmotic concentration of water, how much is maintained in the water, okay, how much is maintained the water, that much based upon in the aquatic region what living of these organisms, what are living of these organisms to maintain same osmotic concentration. That means it can be changes the same osmotic concentrations. So that's why we call it is conformers. Once again, see this point. What are the main water maintain the osmotic concentration, that based upon different season, the water can be maintained the different season, different osmotic concentrations. So that based upon what are the living organisms are present, that living organisms also it can be changed as the same osmotic concentration of the body fluids. So that's why we call it is conformers. Same, we are also human being also, whatever it is, the living organisms also present, such all the living organisms, what are the temperature, what are the osmotic concentration, they maintain the ambient, okay, that means environment, ambient, ambient it is particularly the ambient means surrounding environment, what they maintain, such ambient conditions only, in our body it can be changes to maintain the homeostasis, that's why we call it is the conformers. Next, thermoregulation. Thermoregulation is energetically expansive process. So, thermoregulation energetically it is an expansive process for many animals. Is particularly true for smaller animals such as shrews and also hummingbirds. Thermoregulation is energetical expansive process for smaller animals. It is true such as particularly you can see it is the shrews and also hummingbirds. Shrews means it is the mice like that animals. Mice like the animals. Okay, and also hummingbirds. Here see how it is the thermal regulation is energetically expansive process. I'll say the example. So here heat loss. Heat gain is a function of surface area. Smaller animals, how you can see, smaller animals are more surface area relative to their value. Such animals lost their body heat very fast when it colder in outside. How they are getting, how they are maintaining homeostasis? They are expend much energy. They are expend much energy. That means to generate, they expend much energy to the formation of heat through the metabolism. So that's why finally it reaches the homeostasis. So that's why such a reason based upon smaller animals cannot live in the polar regions. Smaller animals cannot live in the polar regions. So that's why the thermoregulation, it is energetically expensive process. It is true. Suppose for example it is some of the shrews and also hummingbirds. Once again this form mechanism, the heat loss and heat gain is a function of surface area. The smaller animals, the smaller organisms, surface area more relative their value. Such animals lost their body heat very fast when colder it's outside. Colder climatic conditions are present outside. So that's why how they maintain homeostasis means the expenditure of more energy to generate the heat through the process of metabolism. Okay, the expenditure of much energy to generate the heat through metabolism. So that's why the smaller animals to maintain the homeostasis in a colder climatic condition. So that's why the smaller animals are rarely found in the polar regions. Okay, these are the conformers. Once again see, the conformers means majority of the animals and plants cannot maintain the constant internal environment. What are the surrounding atmosphere temperature and also osmotic concentration? It can be changes. The surrounding, what are the animals, that means a living organism present, they maintain same type of it is the temperature and also osmotic concentration. So that means depending upon situation of atmosphere temperature and osmotic concentration based upon what are the organisms are living, such organisms they are maintain their body temperature and also osmotic concentration. That means they maintain the constant internal environment. Such organisms we call it is a conformers. Okay, so that's it is the conformers. Already we discussed the thermoregulation, how it is maintained, the smaller animals.